Now let's look at some lesser-known Google Insider tips. You're probably aware that placing quotation marks around a phrase searches for an exact phrase. This is helpful when you are searching for a common multiple-word phrase or for a popular quote. Using the Control and F keys on your keyboard opens up a search function. You can search for a word or phrase on the page you have loaded. This actually isn't a Google feature, it's a Microsoft feature, but it works for websites too. On a Mac, use the Command F keys. Also, word order matters. The words at the beginning of your search carry more weight in a Google search than the words at the end, so place your most needed search terms first. Google skips small words like the, is, etc., unless they're in quotation marks. You may not be aware that Google has some operators that can greatly benefit your searches. The site operator allows you to search for a specific domain type or specific website. For example, you could search for refugee crisis and limit your results to only .gov sites, or a specific website like congress.gov. When using any Google operator, make sure that you do not include a space between the colon after the operator and the limiter. Your search should be refugee space crisis space site colon gov with no space between the colon and gov. File type will return results in a specific format. You can search for PDFs, Excel sheets, PowerPoints, Word documents, and more. Using a dash works like a minus sign. This signifies what words should not appear in any of your results. Remember our Jaguar example earlier in the advanced search? This works the same way. If I'm looking for information about a Jaguar animal, and I don't want any results about the car company Jaguar, then I would search for Jaguar, space, minus car, with no space between the minus and car. The in title operator allows you to search for a word or phrase only in the titles of documents. Every result will have your search terms in the title. Let's try another Google challenge. I want you to search for a PowerPoint about the inventor Tesla, but omit any results about the Tesla coil. How many can you find? Try this in both Google Scholar and Google.com. Pause the video and give it a try, then I'll tell you how I searched. Okay, so here's how I searched. I searched for the term Tesla, then I omitted all results with the word coil in them by including minus coil. Lastly, I limited my results to PowerPoints by including the operator file type colon PPT. The order of the operators doesn't matter. You should get the same results no matter which order you put the operators in. So, how many results did you find? On the date of this recording, November 21st, 2015, I found 6,550 in Google.com and 1 in Google Scholar. In this bonus section, we will learn how to use your Google Scholar library and how to integrate results from the library subscription to Gale into your Google Scholar results. You can save articles to your Scholar library. The only catch is, you have to be signed in to your Google account. As you quickly scan the results page, you can save articles that you want to look at more closely later. The only way to save articles is from the results screen. Once you click on an article title, you are navigated out of Google to that web page. To save an article, simply click the Save button at the bottom right corner of each result. To access your saved results, click the My Library button in the left menu. Once you are in your library, you can categorize your articles by assigning them labels. In my library, I have created two labels, Internet Marketing and Social Media, and Librarianship. To create a label, click on Manage Labels, then create a new label. To assign a label to an article, click on the title of the article, Then click the Labels button and add a label. Access articles assigned to a certain label by clicking on the label name from your library screen. If your computer or laptop is hooked up to the campus wireless, then you can include results from Gale databases provided by the library with your Google Scholar results. To do that, click the Settings button in the upper right corner of the Google Scholar home screen. Then click the Library Links button in the left menu. Conduct a search for Central Penn College. Then checkmark the box next to Central Penn College Gale Full Text, and finally click Save. Now you'll be able to see results from Google Scholar and results from Gale. Results from Gale will include a link in the right pane that says Gale Full Text. Clicking on this link will navigate you out of Google Scholar and into Gale. Thank you for listening to this session about Google Scholar. If you have any questions about Google Scholar, contact the library.